Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, my name is Johannes Vogel. I'm the Director General of the Natural History Museum here in Berlin, and I'm really, really excited to see you all here. We are very proud to have such a distinguished international audience, and I think that is warranted by the fantastic theme of this conference, trying to look at nature through the lens of art and perhaps through the performance of art, through the lens of nature. It's up to you to let your imagination run wild. We need to reflect on these issues because I think that the importance that nature plays for us as humans is still completely underestimated. Last week, a very interesting report was published looking at all major sections of business that keep us running in the world. And all of them discount for nature. So if in any area of business you factor in the ecosystem services that are taken for granted, the things that nature provide, which are taken for granted in the economic imaginations, then no business on earth would be profitable. So we have to achieve a different perception of the importance of nature for the sustainability of human life on earth. And nature sciences fail in this attempt, quite miserable. Nevertheless, the Natural History Museum here in Berlin has now become the most visited museum in Berlin. So we do attract about 820,000 people to come to us and learn and engage with us in dialogue about nature. But that is still not enough. The arts have a completely different way of reaching people through the way they use emotions. And I think there is, in my opinion, a very important intersection to be had here to look at how art and culture engage with people, make them feel relevant, wanted, give them some pride, and how nature, I would regard as a very important topic, can be put more at center stage in the global debates. So I think exploring these intersections is very important. Having all of you here to look at how we can have fun with this topic, but also perhaps get some serious and interesting results out of it, is a great joy for me to see you all here. So we have very, very distinguished speakers. We are very proud to cooperate on this program with the Kulturstiftung des Bundes. And I'm very pleased that Frau Haas is here and going to say a few words now. So enjoy the conference and thank you very much.
Ja, guten Morgen, meine sehr geehrten Damen und Herren, Ladies and Gentlemen. On behalf of the German Federal Cultural Foundation, I'm very pleased to welcome you to this international conference, Art Nature. As you certainly know, our collaboration with the Natural History Museum here in Berlin intends to realize a project that could serve as a model for other museums and collections in the field of science and art and nature. So we are very happy to have you here with all your expertise and all your questions. Apart from presenting art in a natural history museum, we as a foundation are very interested in the answers to questions like, what does art have to say in a context where we want to learn more about our Earth history? How to avoid art being mistaken as another didactic action? What kind of art is most suitable for natural history museums? Life arts, literature, visual arts? And how can art be visible among stars like Tristan and Knut? Talking about lessons learned, there's one thing we already know. To realize a model project like this, you need a very, very special person being in charge. A person who is able to communicate with passion, knowledge, and charm with the artists, the scientists, and the curators. So thank you very much, Anita Hermannstetter, for your enthusiasm. And for your curiosity to explore and to understand all aspects of our project. And thank you, curators and artists, being part of this long-term experiment. I wish all of us a very inspiring meeting here in Naturkunde Museum Berlin, one of our favorite museums in Berlin, with the most visitors of all museums last year. Congratulations. So thank you and enjoy.
Thank you, Kirsten. Ladies and gentlemen, dear guests and colleagues, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all of you as well and give you an idea of the kind of questions I'm looking forward to discussing with you. This conference is dedicated to the subject of contemporary art in natural history museums and natural history collections. We'll be looking at the various forms that collaboration may take, at its opportunities and also at its potential limits, and at the expectations that each side in this partnership has to the other and the ways in which they experience each other. I'm delighted that the conference has met with such a warm response and that all the artists, curators, researchers, and museum professionals that we have asked for contributions have been willing to present their project and concepts and to engage in an exchange of ideas and experience. I'd like to start out by giving you a little introduction on the museum's current work with contemporary art. In 2014, together with the German Cultural Foundation, we launched our model project called Art Nature Artistic Interventions at the Museum für Naturkunde Berlin. Our aim is to experimentally transcend the communicative barriers between the art world and the natural history museum. We want to open up fresh perspectives both on nature and on museum culture, and to shed new light on research objects. Working with external curators, we invite artists to give their own interpretation of our research museum and its collections. Now, 3 years and 7 very different interventions later, we have gained a lot of experience that we would like to discuss here at the conference with you, and we are looking forward to hearing of your own experiences with similar collaborations, projects, and programs. So, why contemporary art in a natural history museum? Despite the introduction of Johannes Vogel, this is a question I often heard in the last 3 years. Some might say that there are art museums for that right next door, the Hamburger Bahnhof. They might argue that we already attract many visitors, that we have great exhibition designs and fascinating objects, some of which are works of art in their own right. In other words, we are doing fine as it is, so why should we need contemporary art? I've been told this several times, and even I would agree natural history museums have always been unusually successful in their ability to appeal to a large general public and generate enthusiasm for their exhibits and subject areas. They all have also always worked closely with artists and used artistic techniques in their study and representation of nature. Nevertheless, I'm sure that many of us agree as well that border-crossing collaborations between contemporary art and natural history museum are illuminating, inspiring, and rewarding. A brief look at the conference program will show that there are many different answers to the question, why? It's about opening new perspectives, provoking conversations, moving natural history museums through choreography, merging different areas of knowledge, or mediating difficult legacies. These kind of impulses and objectives, alongside the experience we have already gained in different museums and collections, show the potential of working together. This partnership is about opening up new conceptual spaces and aesthetic central worlds of experience, productively integrating different methods and knowledge practices, critically questioning inherently complex and difficult issues and acting together on topical, even urgent questions such as the relationship between humans and nature, an issue that has intensely occupied Natural History Museum and the art world alike. But what does it actually mean to place contemporary art in the context of a natural history museum, where compared to art museums and to art galleries, different communication strategies prevail, the public is distinctly more mixed, and the way that visitors behave is quite different. What new perspectives, what new knowledge, what different learning experiences emerge from this collaboration? How does contemporary art change the way we experience nature and natural history museums and vice versa? How do natural history museums change the way we experience the arts? How do visitors respond to cross-disciplinary experiments like this and to new unfamiliar concepts? What the conditions are needed and what measures do we have to take in order to inspire productive invitation and a successful interplay between art and natural history? Lastly, and very importantly, how do we find the right partners? We'll be looking at all these questions over the next 2 days, and I'm especially pleased that we've been able to bring together such a wide variety of artists, curators, and researchers, some of whom have been working for real years at the borders between art, science, and natural history, or observing these processes from the outside. And now, before closing, I'd like to offer one first answer. Time to get to know each other and share our knowledge, our ideas and experience is indispensable for productive dialogue. That is why we have included a lot of time and space to talk during the conference and at the reception in the museum this evening, where you can meet and speak with the artists Clara Hopsa and Monika Rink about their current interventions in our museum. I'd like to encourage you to use these opportunities for a closer exchange and dialogue, and I wish all of us a stimulating and enriching time together. So now I'm very pleased that we have been able to recruit Petra Lange-Berndt as our keynote lecturer, and she will start things off by giving us some insights of how contemporary art has approached natural history museums and collections. Petra is the chair for modern and contemporary art at the University of Hamburg and works as curator as well. She recently curated the exhibition with Mark Dye in the Academy of Things in Dresden. And in her research, she is investigating the natural history complex in relation to contemporary art. Dear Petra, we are looking forward to your contribution and also to hear more about sticky materialities.